是一个一位奉献者，他在寻求绝对灵性的真理，他去恒河的入海处去卡皮拉的阿舍去找卡皮拉。
Not, no, he wasn't going to find Kapila. Kapila wouldn't be there. It's a place of pilgrimage.
Oh, 他不是sorry。他不是去找那个卡皮拉，他是去那里朝圣，但那地方是一个朝圣之地。
So Maharaja Hogan needed someone to carry his palanquin, so they thought Jad Bharat would do it because he had a good strong body, so they had him become one of the four carriers. You know, they have four people carry the palanquin, so he was one of the four.
但这个国王呢，他需要抬轿子的人，需要4位轿夫，其中呢，他缺了一个轿夫，就找来了扎的，Bharat 来充当轿夫的角色。
But Jad Bharat was very careful that he didn't want to step on any insects who were on the path. So he would walk very slowly and very carefully so that he would not crush any insects.
Jad Bharat 他小心翼翼的，不要踩到任何的小昆虫，所以他走得非常的慢，因为他十分的小心。
So this caused the other palanquin carriers, they were walking at a different speed because the other palanquin carriers, they were Sudras and they didn't care about other forms of life. They just walked. So they were walking fast, but Jad Bharat was walking very slow, so it caused some disturbance to the king who was in the palanquin, that he was caused to have to be shaken around in the palanquin.
别的轿夫走得非常快，而扎德巴拉的呢走得非常慢，这就使得坐在轿子里的国王呢非常的心烦意乱，因为这个轿子就是抬得很不稳。
So when the king understood what was happening, the king spoke very harsh words and very insulting words to Jad Bharat, and he threatened to have him beaten.
国王就非常的烦心，所以他就说出的话非常尖刻又难听，侮辱对扎德巴拉的呢加以侮辱，甚至要打他。
But Jad Bharat replied to the words of the king. He replied to the words of the king, revealing himself to be a very enlightened, spiritually advanced personality.
Jad Bharat 的对国王的回答呢，显示出他是一个已经开悟了的灵性上非常进步的人物。
Everything the king had said about Jad Bharat had been countered by Jad Bharat in his reasoning. For example, the king was saying that, you know, you're not the carrier. The king would say like, I know you must be very tired. You're carrying the palanquin, but Jad Bharat would say, no, actually, I'm not carrying the palanquin. I'm a soul, I'm only in the body. My body may be carrying the palanquin, but I don't carry it.
比如说，国王说：“哎，我知道你一定抬着轿子，非常累了。扎德巴拉的就说：“你说的没错，我的躯体在抬着轿子，但是我并没有抬着轿子，因为我是灵魂。”
And Jadbarat told the king that you think you're the king, but actually you're not the king. You may be the king for some time, but actually you're a soul living in the body of a king. You think I'm your servant. I'm not your servant. I'm a soul living in a body which you want to serve you. So in this way, Jadbarat revealed himself to the king as being a very great devotee, a very spiritually advanced person. And when the king heard these words, then the king was very disturbed, and he understood that he had offended a great devotee. But Jadbarat never considered himself a great devotee, and he considered whatever happened to him to be just the results of his past karma. He thought that this job which he'd been given to carry the king's palanquin was his karma, it was some reaction from his past, and he had taken on the service. But the king, when he heard that how Jadbarat had spoken, then the king immediately got down from the palanquin and he came and he fell at the feet of Jadbarat. Now the king, being in the position of being a king and being carried in a palanquin, gave him a lot of ego. But the words which Jadbarat had spoken were full of deep philosophy and deep meaning, and they smashed his false ego. So the king, but due to the words of Jadbarat, the king gave up that idea of thinking himself as the king, and he became humble. And he came to Jadbarat and fell at his feet in such a way that he was showing that he was asking to be forgiven for the words, the harsh, insulting words which he'd spoken. So then Maharaj Rahugana prayed to Jadbarat that he said that, you know, I can see that you're wearing a Brahmin thread. So he said, I can understand you must become some kind of brahmana, or you're some kind of saintly person. But you didn't look like one because you were so covered with dirt, and I couldn't understand your position.
Rahugana, 佩戴着 Brahma 的圣线，看上去就像您应该是一位圣人，可是您的外表呢，就身上有着尘土，您的外表并不像一个圣人的样子，所以我就不明白。
I think you must be some kind of liberated soul who just travels the world without letting people know who you are, without notifying anybody.
您是一个解脱了的灵魂，您在这个世上旅行，不愿意让世人知道，注意到您。
So the king asked Jadbharat, he said,Who's your teacher? Whose disciple are you? Where did you learn all this knowledge from? And where do you live? What's your place of residence? What's your mission in coming here? Are you trying to do some good for people like me?Please let me know who you are.
您住在哪里？您的居所在哪？您的使命是什么？我看见您好像是到这里是为了给世人带来好处，给像我这样的人带来好处。我想知道您是谁。
So, there are two ways in which one may be connected to.A family of spiritual knowledge. One is by birth in a Brahmana family, and the other is by initiation into the disciplic succession.
与一个有着灵性知识的家庭产生联系有两种方式。一种方式呢是投生在一个 Brahmana Brahman 的家庭当中，另外一种方式呢，是在一个使徒传契当中得到启迪。
Yes, if we're initiated into the Sampradaya, a bona fide Sampradaya, then we're connected to the Brahmana family, to a great Brahmana family of great Acharyas.
或者是我们在一个与一个真正的使徒传契。有联系，从这个指出传获得启迪，或者是我们出生在伟大的 Ramana 或者是伟大的 Achar 的家庭当中一个人。
It's important to approach a spiritual teacher to get knowledge. So Maharaj Rahugana was accepting Jadbharat like a guru.
接近一位灵性导师来寻求知识。这一点非常重要的。Rahugana Maharaj 便把 Jadbharat 接受为他的 guru。
But you don't just become a guru just by wearing a sacred thread, just by having a Brahmin thread round your neck. You have to have advanced knowledge of spiritual life.
仅仅是这你身上套着一条圣线，并不够。这一点呢，并不代表什么。一个人还必须要获得进步的灵性的知识，有进步的有灵性上的生活。
So the birth in the family is very helpful to get that kind of education, spiritual knowledge. You're born in a Brahmana family, or you're initiated into the line of disciplic succession.
或者是同生在 Brahmana 的家庭当中，或者是。经过启迪进入一个使徒传系，这两点都能有助于一个人得到灵性知识。
But if we want spiritual knowledge, it's very important to approach a spiritual teacher. And the spiritual teacher should be properly qualified.
因此要获取灵性知识的话，必须要接近一位灵性导师，但是这位灵性老师他一定是必须有合格的灵性导师。
One qualification is that you're born in the Brahmana family, so from childhood you learn from, you just like Srila Prabhupada, Prabhupada was not born in a caste Brahmana family, but he was born in a family, his father was a devotee, and he worshipped Radha and Krishna deities.
其实一个知名啊，就是出生在一个Brahma的家庭，从小就有机会接触到灵性的知识，但是并不是说一个人投生在一个种姓的佛陀的家庭，比如说像圣帕巴德，他出生在奉献者的家庭，他父亲就崇拜着 Radha Krishna.
And when Srila Prabhupada was a young child, he wanted to do Rath Yatra, and his father arranged it for him. His father arranged for all the young children to come together, and they put on a Rath Yatra festival. This is one of the benefits of being born in a devotee Brahmana family.
这是出生在奉献者婆罗门家庭当中的好处。
In the same way, Srila Prabhupada's spiritual teacher, Om Vishnupad Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada, he was also born in a Brahmana Vaishnava family. His father was the great devotee Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So birth in a devotee Brahmana family means from the very beginning of one's birth, one has the opportunity to be trained as a devotee.
出生在 Brahmana Vaishnava 之家，就意味着一个人从小就有机会在灵性上获得训练。On
the other hand, one may be initiated as a Brahmana by the take second birth with the initiation and become a Brahmana by initiation, Vaishnava initiation.
同样的一个人也可以获得启迪，成为一位Brahmana，他得到二次启迪，得到一个Vaishnava的二次启迪。So,
the actual qualification for becoming a Brahmana is that not only one must be initiated, but one has to be trained by a qualified spiritual teacher.
不仅仅是得到启迪，还是要得到领导师的训练。One
who is Brahmana is expected to know the scriptures and study the scriptures and to teach the scriptures.
一位 Brahmana 他应该研习经典，教导经典。Or
they're expected to worship the deity and teach others to worship the deity.
Brahmana 理应崇拜神像, 并且教导他人该如何崇拜神像。
We are often approached by people who want to be second initiated, but they don't do these things. They don't study the scriptures very much, and they don't worship the deities very much.
有的人他们会接近灵性导师，想从领导那里获得二次启迪。然而这些人，他们自己并不去研习经典，也并不去崇拜神像。So
it's important that they should study scriptures, and they should also take part in the worship of the deities.
所以他们应当研习经典，并且参加。
Sometimes you get devotees, they don't even know how to offer arti.
有的奉献者甚至都并不知道该怎么供奉 arti。
Every devotee should take some time, should take some turn to offer arti to the for the pleasure of the deities.
每一位奉献者都应该轮流为了取悦神像来为神像供奉 arti。
Devotees want to be second initiated. There are other spiritual teachers in ISKCON that they will require that before they will give second initiation to a disciple, they must have completed the Bhakti Shastri course.
In ISKCON, 想要得到二四级之前，他必须要通过了 Bhakti Sastra 风爱经典课程的考试。
But some people, they want second initiation. Without this, they just simply read the books and they don't remember anything.
但是有的人，他们想得到二四级，他们就没有符合，并不符合要求，他们只是在那里读书，什么也记不住。
So the Brahman initiation is given as a facility to do more service.
Brahman 的启迪只是给一个人便利条件去从事更多的服务。
That you will worship the deity and you will give classes, you'll give teachings to the other devotees.
他们之后呢可以去从事崇拜神像讲课给别人教导
because you're second initiated these are expected this is expected from those who are second initiated
因为您已经二次启迪了那如果获得了二次启迪之后呢他理应应该从事上述的这些活动
so It's a responsibility. Sometimes people want second initiation, they're not even chanting 16 rounds. But you want second initiation, you have to chant another 210 mantras every day. 210.
一个 Brahmana 他应该履行自己的职责有的奉献者甚至能念十六圈除了念诵十六圈之外他理应还应该念诵另外210个 mantra
because the Gayatri mantra is chanted three times a day and there are seven mantras to be chanted each timeAnd each mantra is chanted 10 times. So 3 times a day, times 7, times 10, equals 210.
所以念诵人应当 Brahmana 应该一天三次吟诵 Gayatri mantra. 这 Gayatri mantra 呢它是就是每一首 mantra 是念诵十遍。一共七首 mantra 在一天三次就是三乘七乘十加210
So if you cannot chant 16 rounds why do you need to chant Gayatri mantra?
如果您还念不了十六圈那还有什么必要去念 Gayatri mantra 呢
The qualification for the chanting of the Gayatri mantraIs one should be more situated more in the mode of goodness and away from the modes of passion and ignorance. So Maharaj Rahugana got down from the palanquin and he fell at the feet of Jadbharat.And then he offered prayers, begging forgiveness.
Maharaj
And he told him, he said, I'm not afraid of the thunderbolt of King Indra, and I'm not afraid of the trident of Lord Shiva.
他说，并不惧怕，Indra，天帝Indra的霹雳，也不惧怕主Shiva的三叉戟。
I'm not afraid of the punishment of Yamaraj, the god of death.
我并不惧怕死神Yamaraj的惩罚。
I'm not afraid of fire, or the scorching heat of the sun, or the wind, or the weapon of Kuvera.
也不惧怕太阳的酷热，或者是强风，也不怕苦烈热的武器。
But I am afraid of offending Arjuna. I'm very much afraid of this.
我却惧怕冒犯一位 Brahmana， 我十分恐惧这一点。
So Lord Chaitanya also taught when he was teaching Rupa Goswami at Prayag.At the junction of the Ganga and the Yamuna, Lord Chaitanya taught Rupa Goswami. And he taught, one of the things he taught him was to be very careful not to ever offend a Vaishnava, a devotee.
因此，主持的念妈妈布在普拉亚的恒河、亚穆纳河的交汇处连续教导 Rupa Goswami, 他教导他的其中一条就是小心不要冒犯 Vaishnava 奉献者。
So Maharaj Rahugana mentioned many dangerous things, but the most dangerous thing was to offend a devotee.
Maharaj Rahugana 他提及了很多危险的事物，但是他提及了最危险的一件事物就是冒犯奉献者。
That's the most serious, so we must be very careful in our dealings with devotees.
这是最为严重的事件，所以当我们跟奉献者交往的时候，一定要非常小心。
We can lose all our spiritual advancement very easily by the mad elephant offense.
因为奉献这个冒犯，我们可以非常容易的失去一切灵性的进步。
So Maharaj Rahugana told Jadbharat, he said that you have so much spiritual knowledge, but you were hiding it, you were not revealing it to us.
Rahugana 大君就对 Jadbharat 说。您拥有这么多灵性知识，然而您却把它们都隐藏起来了，并没有暴露出来。
So the king asked him, he said, why are you wandering around like you're some kind of madman?
他问国王问扎巴拉的，您为什么像疯子一样四处漫游呢？
It's not possible for us to understand if the words which you have spoken are so full of knowledge and so deep in wisdom that it's very difficult for me to understand what you have said. So can you kindly explain it to me?
您所说的一切话都不可能理解，您说的话充满着知识和深深的智慧，普通人很难理解。您能否好心的对我加以解释呢？
Somebody like Jadbharat, who is so advanced, such an elevated person, when he speaks, he does not speak ordinary words. He's speaking on a very high platform, so ordinary people cannot understand.
这样进步承包的奉献者开口讲话所说的话并不是普通的话语。只有非常高度进步的人才能理解，普通人很难理解。
The people who listen must also be advanced in order to understand the words of such people when they speak.
聆听的人也必须非常进步, 才能理解像Jagannatha这样崇高进步的人所说的话。
That's why Lord Krishna did not just speak Bhagavad Gita to anyone. He selected Arjuna to receive the Bhagavad Gita.
当主Krishna讲述《薄伽梵歌》的时候，并不是对随便一个人讲述。
In Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Bhaktosime sakacheti rahasyam hihe tadutama. Krishna tells Arjuna that I'm speaking to you because you are my devotee and also my very good friend. Therefore, you can understand this knowledge. So, what great personalities, they don't waste their time speaking to the sudras, to the working, ordinary people, unintelligent people, because they know they won't understand.
会浪费时间向苏者向普通的缺乏智慧的人讲话，因为他们是不会理解的。Lord
Chaitanya only spoke philosophy with very special intimate devotees who were very advanced.
就柴达涅马哈布只向那些非常进步的特殊的亲密的奉献者来讲话。
He would speak with people like Ramananda Rai and Swarup Damodar. These people, they were very intimate with Lord Chaitanya. But for the ordinary people, Lord Chaitanya would have Sankirtan. Let them take part in the Sankirtan. And in this way they can advance by chanting the Hare Krishna mantra. And when they get purified by chanting the Hare Krishna mantra, then they will be able to understand the words of the scriptures like Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam. But they, ordinary people cannot understand the words of the advanced devotees, very advanced devotees.
普通人不能理解非常进步的奉献者到底讲的是什么。
But they can take the shelter of a devotee, a Vaishnava, who knows how to enlighten such people. And they can present the Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam on a simple, basic level, so that even the uneducated people can understand.
可以以一种非常简单的基础来呈现《薄伽梵歌》《薄伽瓦坛》，好让普通人能够接受。Prabhupada said
when he first went to hear his own spiritual master, he said he could not understand what he was speaking about. It was difficult for him to understand.
也说，当他第一次见到自己的灵性导师的时候，并不理解他的灵性导师在说什么。But
he kept hearing, he didn't go away, and gradually it began to make sense.
但是他不断的聆听，他并没有走开，这样逐渐的他就理解了。So
the king said to Jatparat, he said, you're a very exalted personality, and you have descended just to give benefit to the human society.
王就对扎德巴尔的马儿说，您是一个崇高的人物，您的降临只是为了裨益人类社会。
You've come to give spiritual knowledge. You are a representative of Lord Kapiladev, the incarnation of God, who taught Sankhya Yoga.
您在传授着灵性知识，您是神的化身，卡皮拉的代表，您在教授着 Sankhya Yoga.
Because remember the king, he was going to Kapila Muni's ashram. He was going there to the Ganga Sagar.Where Kapila Muni had his ashram. So Kapila, the king was a follower of Lord Kapila. So then the king said to Jadbharat, he said, O spiritual master,What is the most secure shelter in this world? So remember, Jadbharat had been Bharat Maharaj 2 births ago. He was bornAs Bharat Maharaj, he was in a royal family, he was a great king. Then he'd become a deer. Now he's Jadbharat from the family of a Brahmana. And he'd got all the knowledge, he'd developed all this knowledge about the Supreme Lord. So he could be taken as a representative of the Supreme Lord, a representative of Krishna, just like we sing every day, the spiritual master is the representative of God. Sakshat Daritvena Samasta Shastri.
可以把詹巴拉的当成是 Krishna 至尊主的代表，因为我们每天在八颂灵诗里就唱到了这个歌 Satshadri Nasamasta Shastri.
The spiritual master is not God, but he's the representative of God because he gives the knowledge of God to others.
灵性导师本身并不是神，但他却是神的代表，因为他把知识授予其他人。
So, Jadbharat was seen. The king understood Jadbharat was a representative like that. He saw and he asked him about the Atma Tattva. He wanted to understand the science of the soul from him.
这里国王就把扎德巴拉的就当成了神的代表。他想从他那里获得阿兹玛塔的吧，关于灵性的灵魂的知识。
If you want to know about the soul, you have to hear it from the spiritual master. You have to get this knowledge from the spiritual teachers. You don't just get it on your own. You have to get it through the authorized channel, through a person who is actually educated and trained in this knowledge.
如果想获得有关灵魂的知识，必须要从一个灵性导师那里来获取这门知识。你不能自学成才，必须要从一位连权威的渠道那里获得这门教导，并且受到训练。
So the king says, I see you as a representative of Kapiladev. You're not different. You're passing on the same knowledge as Lord Kapila gave.
所以国王就说，我看出您就是卡皮拉帝的代表，您能授予这门知识。
And you just appeared like some dumb person, you just disguise yourself to be some dumb person so that you can understand who is actually the real person, who is a human being and who is not. So the king said, I'm very attached to family life and worldly activities, and I have no spiritual knowledge.
我没有丝毫的灵性知识。
So I'm putting myself before you. I want you to enlighten me. How can I advance in spiritual life?
我把自己置于您面前，希望得到您的启迪，如何在灵性知识方面取得进步？
So the king, previously he'd been thinking himself to be the king. But Jad Bharat had told him, actually, you're not the king. Your body may be playing the part of the king, but you're not a king. You're a soul.
近期之前，这位国王一直把他自己当做一位国王。然而，扎德巴拉玛拉告诉他：“您并不是国王，您的躯体可能扮演着国王的角色，但您是灵魂。”
And Jad Bharat also wasn't some dumb person. He also was a soul in the body. So the body is never equal with the soul. The body, the activities of the body are all just temporary in connection with the material world.
灵魂永远不能和躯体同等对待，躯体它从事这样各种各样的短活动，全都是短暂的，而且它都是在这个受到物质世界的影响。So
the king was convinced about this, and he was very eager to get knowledge from Jad Bharat. He was accepting Jad Bharat as his guru.
国王对此已经确定无疑了，他非常渴望获得知识，因此便把扎德巴拉当成他的guru了。Tadvijnanartham
sagurum eva begachit, from the Mundaka Upanishad. Mundaka Upanishad is a Vedic text, and in the Vedic text it says one must get knowledge from a spiritual master. It's essential. You have to approach a guru to get knowledge.
所以根据《Mundaka Upanishad》，这是一部伟大的典籍。这部是经典，就宣称一个人要获得知识，必须要接近一个灵性导师，这点至关重要。You
have to find a person like Jad Bharat, who is full and who is very rich in spiritual knowledge, and you have to take the mood of somebody like Maharaj Rahugana. You have to become humble, and you have to become eager to know how to get this knowledge, how to make advancement.
渴望在灵性知识方面进步。So
the king remembered all the words which Jad Bharat had spoken, and he reminded Jad Bharat, he said, you said you were not tired from carrying the palanquin, because the soul is different from the body.
您说您抬轿子并不累，因为您是灵魂，您不同于这个躯体。So
the body would get tired, but I would think the soul would also feel some tiredness.
你躯体会感到疲劳, 但是我认为灵魂也会疲劳。
Yeah, because although the body is doing the work, the soul also feels some attachment for the work which is taking place. So the king said, this is my thinking about things.
因为躯体在从事着工作活动，然而灵魂也同样依附着这躯体所从事的工作，这就是我的观点。
And you said that the behavior between the master and the servant is not real. It's not actually true. That nobody is actually, you're not actually the master. I'm not actually the master and you're not my servant. You said like that. So the material world may not be eternal, may not be real, but the things which are going on in this world, they do affect us.
这个世界上的所发生的事情虽然并非永恒，也并不是真实的，但它们确实会影响到我们。
So the material activities are not permanent, but they cannot be said to be illusion. You can't say they're not real.
这个物质世界的物质的活动，它们并非永恒的，但是它们并不是不真实的。
So you can see this is the king is bringing up this point. He's discussing about the difference between the philosophy of the Mayavadi and the Vaishnava.
看到国王现在开始讨论的就是关于 Mayavadi 哲学和 Vaishnava 哲学之间的关系。
The Mayavadis, they say this material world is not real.But the Vaishnavas do not agree. We say, no, the world is real, but it is, we say the world may be temporary, but it is not false, it's real.
Mayavada 哲学认为这个物质世界是不真实的，但是根据 Vaishnava 哲学，这个物质世界虽然短暂，它们却是真实的。他们不是虚假的。
To give an example, just like at night when you go to sleep and you have a dream, so you may have a dream, and maybe a very terrible dream. So it maybe it's not real because it's a dream, but still because it's such a terrible dream, it affects you. You wake up, you feel shaken by it.You feel disturbed by the bad dream.
比如说在夜晚的时候，一个人可能会做梦，他睡觉的时候做了非常可怕的梦。这个梦虽然是不真实，然而这个非常恐怖的梦境会影响到做梦的人，可能会让他从梦魇当中醒过来，感到非常恐惧。
So the tiredness which we are feeling, it's not real so long as we're in the spiritual platform. If you can understand you're not the body, then you're not disturbed by it.
对躯体感到疲累，只要一个人在灵性层面上，那么他这个疲劳是不真实的，他并不会影响到一个人。
But if we are in the bodily, if we're thinking we're the body, then certainly we will feel tired.
但是如果一个人他认为他是躯体的话，那无疑他会感到疲劳。
So we suffer due to it. We will suffer due to our dreams.
因此，我们会因为我们所做的梦而受苦。
Another example is the water pot is made from clay, and it is temporary.
另外一个例子就是冰雪罐是用陶土所组成的，它是短暂的。
So we could say, well, there's no water pot, there's only clay. There's just simply clay.
我们便可以说成没有什么陶，这个水罐，也只是陶土而已，全都是土。
But we use that water pot to hold water, and it can perform many functions. It's useful in the form of the water pot.
因为我们去使用这个水罐，我们把它当成它的功能是非常有用的呀。
So we cannot say the water pot is not real. It's real.
因此我们并不能声称这个水罐是虚假的，这个水罐是真实的。
Then the king gives some more things which Jadbarat had been saying. He said, you know, Jadbarat said that designations like the body being fat or thin, that they're not the real characteristics of the soul.
So,所谓的就是躯体胖瘦这样的特点，这样头衔，他们就是躯体的特征。
But the king said, I don't agree, because if we feel some pain or we feel some pleasure, that is also felt by the soul.
影响到了灵魂。
It gives an example. He said, just like if you put milk and rice in a pot and you put it on the fire, then the milk and rice are heated.
他举一个例子，把牛奶和大米就是混合在一起，放在罐里头加热。
So in the same way, the body feels pain and pleasure is also felt by the soul, is also felt by the mind, is also felt by the senses.
躯体已感受到的痛苦和快乐，心意也感受到了，感官也感受到了。
And the soul is not separate from this.And then the king said also that you said that the relationship between the king and the subject, or the relationship between the master and the disciple, are not eternal. You said that such relationships are temporary.
国王和他的臣民之间的关系，主人和门徒之间的关系，他们是短暂的。
But the king says, when a person takes the position of a king, his duty is to rule the citizens and punish them if they disobey the laws.
国王他的职责就是当臣民。倘若要违法乱纪的话，国王有责任惩罚这样的人。
By punishing them, he teaches the citizens to obey the laws.
通过惩罚他们，他教导市民该如何遵纪守法。
But you said also that punishing a person is like, it's like grinding the.It's great grinding pulp, that there's no benefit to it. Or it's like chewing the chewed, that there's no benefit to it. Haribol Gurumani. Haribol, you will like how? Did you hear the last sentence?
Yes,
so the king is arguing, he said, if I'm doing my duty, my occupational duty, then that is good for me, it will reduce my sinful reactions.
Hare Krishna, Gurmati Mataji, you are very sweet. You can
look
at the position before. Before, it was very good. Before, it was very
good.
Now, it's better. Now, it's better. Now, it's 对，您再重新翻译一下吧，没听见最后这一句的。
国王就对加德巴拉的玛哈拉就是说，您说惩罚一个人是没有用处的，就好像咀嚼已经咀嚼过的食物，或者是碾磨过的谷物一样。
And so the king said, everything you spoke, it appears to me to be contradictory.And the king said, I was puffed up, thinking I was a king, and I certainly became an offender to you, so I ask you to forgive me. We know very dangerous to offend a devotee. I can understand you're a great devotee, you're the real friend of all living entities. You have come to give spiritual knowledge. So please help me to get free from the bodily conception.
就是为了帮助众生，来赐予灵性的知识，请帮助我来摆脱躯体化的概念吧。
So he asked Jadbharat to help him to understand all the instructions which Jadbharat had been giving.Okay, so we will stop. Are there any questions?
Okay.有手机可以看到问题吗？
我打开一下微信。
我发到你微信上吗？
我看一下，我看一下这个 Skype。要不然您还是读，还是您来读。
啊，好的好的。
嗯，谢谢。
好的 ，Lila 马大吉的问题，给白咕噜，感谢翻译。刚才您讲到启迪的重要性，但是有的时候我们会看到灵性导师或许会拒绝一个门徒的启迪，是什么样的原因导致这样的后果呢？作为门徒，我们该以什么样的心态来面对这样的事情呢？
拒绝一个门徒的启迪， 是什么意思？
They don't want to give initiation to somebody, is it?
是不是就是领导是拒绝给一个人起名吗？
They avoid giving, they avoid giving someone initiation. They may feel that they're not the right person, they're not ready to accept that person as their disciple.They may feel the disciple themselves is not ready, or they may feel unqualified themselves to accept that person. Just like sometimes the spiritual master may come, and he may feel that he's not going to come to this place regularly, so he doesn't want to accept disciples in that place because he's not involved with the preaching going on in that place, and he considers it to be inappropriate for him to accept disciples there.Because he doesn't have the intention of coming there regularly. There has to be some rapport, some exchange between the disciple and the spiritual master. The spiritual master should come regularly to give instruction to the disciple, or the disciple should go to see the spiritual master and take instruction from him. There has to be some contact there. There has to be some, you know, if you're not going to get association with the Diksha Guru, then it should come through the Shiksha Guru.
在领导和门徒之间应该有接触，如果不能跟一个自己的弟子以及领导师有联系，他应该跟他的师者，比如就师者领导师有联系。
嗯哼。还有第二部分这个问题，第一部分是为什么解决？第二部分是什么？
第二部分是作为这个奉献者，他该以什么样的心态面对这样的事情？
Well, they have to understand the position. They have to understand that there's no obligation on the part of the spiritual master to accept disciple.
他们得理解，就是灵命导师没有义务接受门徒。
And there are other spiritual masters. They can always approach someone else to find another person to be their spiritual master. There are some disciples who really require a lot of attention. They can be very demanding. They come to the spiritual master and they want to...You know, all the time bother him and even little things they come to the spiritual master about. So some spiritual masters may feel, you know, that I just don't have the time to be able to give to this person, that they want so much attention that I don't have the time to be able to give them all the attention they want. It will be better for them to find another person to be their spiritual master.
他们可以去找别的人，找别的领导师，别的领导可以给予他们所要的关注。
还有问题吗？
我们在这还没有新的问题提上来。
Okay, no more questions. So maybe we can stop here tonight. Okay, Sati, 早一点结束可以吗？
好的，可以的，顾茹。
Okay.
我看。Lila Rasha Madani, 你是要提问吗？没有问题的话我们就结束了。好的 Good day, 我们今天早点结束吧，你也早一些休息。
好，谢谢。So, 感谢 Guru Mani, 感谢 Sati, Srila Prabhupada Ki,
Jai,
Gorbhakta Vrinda Ki,
Jai.
Gaur Premanande.
Hari Hari Bo. Udaiva Ki Jai.